Hello friends, today I am again ready with another video and we are going to talk about how we can add any server detail which is providing the catalog detail freely like Library of Congress. So in other term we call it as a z39.50 protocol, copy cataloging we can say, or metadata harvesting from other server. So in any software these days there is a provision that we don't have to do the duplicate cataloging. Instead we can just enter the record or the based on the ISBN or title or subject, we can pull the data from other server and we can integrate, means we can harvest in our library management system. So we are going to discuss the same today. So I am taking the example in case of Koha library management system. So in order to use that, first we have to click on login button with our login credential. I mean to say that login in your library management system. And then we have to choose Koha administration, and at the bottom right side you will find that there is an option called z39.50 SRU server. So this SRU server will allow us to, this option will allow us to add any server which is not listed here. You can see that there are four targets have been added: Library of Congress for bibliographical detail, and authority file, and this is also for bibliographic SRU server and authority file. So we have to configure similarly the other server also. But before adding to this server administration page, we have to know that from where we can get the detail, or if we are aware, we have to add. Two things are there: if we already know the details about target, host name, database, user ID, password and syntax, whether it is US mark, UK mark, whatever it is, and what is the record type, and accordingly we can integrate. So I am just taking one website which is very useful, that is irspy.indexdata.com, and this website is having the list of all the directories of SRU and SRW targets or Z39.50 targets, which provides the detail, and that detail we can integrate. So we can find the target from this website. How we can do this? Choose find target, and here the text box, freely searchable text box are given. So if I take, we can restrict, we can consider this as a filter to get the directory detail. So I just fix my target, let us take India. So when I take this India, now if I click on search button, so it will pull the data which are providing the cataloging detail on their server. You can see that it has found total 11. But one thing I would like to mention here, that all these servers listed here may not be functional. So now we have to decide that which one is useful or which we have to configure, which can give us data all the time. Because if the server is off, you cannot pull the data from the server. So for that, we have to check the connection reliability. This connection reliability will display the accessibility in the percentage, like 100%. One server, another server is also giving the accessibility percentage 100%. So let us take this example, Texicon, and now we can see here that this has 100% reliability. The host name is also given, port number is given, and this is the database name. Now let us go to Koha administration tool, click on z39.50 server edition, and now I type here Texicon, and I have to enter the host name. Then we have to enter the port and then database name. So the port name is 9998 and the last database name is Biblios. Okay, so let us re-verify. The title of the connection is Texicon, host name is catalog.texicon.in, port name Biblios. Okay, now there is no user ID password, and what will be the format? So these are the known format, so we will take US mark, which is universally accepted. So we can choose here, we have to see, and accordingly we have to select. And the encoding by default it is UTF-8. If you want any other format of encoding, so you can choose. And then which type of record, whether it is authority or bibliographic, accordingly we have to opt. So by default it is bibliographic, and now just click on save button. So this is the process to add the z39.50 server. And one more thing here, by default, if you want, by default now it is set to Library of Congress to pull the data. It means it will be pre-selected. If you want Texicon, this server also to be pre-selected mode, so accordingly it can be given the option pre-selected. So when the record is pulled, or when you are trying to add the record to database, it will allow you to fetch the data from all the pre-selected servers. Now let us go and see whether it is pulling the data or not. So for that we have to click on cataloging, go to cataloging module, and here you will find two options: new record from z39.50. So I take this in the default framework. So it will open another window, and now you can see that our server is also listed here, Texicon, and it is also pre-selected. So I will choose only Texicon and I'll uncheck this. Let us see whether it is working or not. So if I know the ISBN, so I can directly enter here ISBN number. If I do not know, so I have some other options also here, like author, subject, keyword, these are the DV. So from here also we can pull the record. So I just click on here, I enter classification, and then click on search button. Now if the server is on and is working, so it will pull the data related to your keyword you have entered in title. So it may take some time, you have to wait, because it depends on two things. The one, the server which is providing the data, and your system also, the internet speed, whether it is fetching, means fast or slow. So see, we did not find the detail here. It means there is some issue with the server, or maybe sometimes it is not on. If we add the same, means Library of Congress also, and again click on search button, perhaps it may pull the data, because Library of Congress remains functional 24/7. So probability is maximum that we'll be getting the data. And when we get the data, we can directly import into our bibliographic framework. Whatever the framework we are using, by default I have chosen the default framework. This is also not working. It means there is some problem in my internet. If there is a proxy or something, means restricting to fetch the data from other server. So in that case, we have to check, and then we can pull the data from here. So I hope I have been able to make you understand that how we can add the z39.50 protocol or directory, and if we do not know, so where to get the target. So to get the target, we discussed today three things. First, we have to log in with our Koha administration, find the detail of means where we can add. This is the additional parameter, z39.50 server. Second, we have to know the directory. So to find the directory, we can choose here the country wise, or we can specific option also. We can restrict the filter through specific kind of library, academic, public, special, national, whatever. These are the type of library, and then we can search, and whatever the detail means, detail we get, that detail we have to add in our z39.50 server. See, after getting this, we added in this additional parameter z39.50 SRU server. So thank you very much for watching the video. Your comments are most welcome, your suggestions are most welcome. It will really help me to make some more relevant videos for our beloved professionals, library professionals. So thank you very much. Have a nice day.